The president said he wanted to get rid of the bad ones, the criminals, the rapists he was talking about. But now it seems like they want to go after every single undocumented worker. I'm not saying nobody should be deported, but this idea that we're going to deport 10 or 11 million people, folks that are here building a better life, I can't go along with that.
The mayor of Michigan's capital city, Lansing, weighing in on immigration reform as the White House reportedly plans for a nationwide deportation force. The mayor concerned about the potential for mass deportation, but just 1 week after the city council voted to make Lansing, Michigan's first formal sanctuary city, last night it said it would reverse using that phrase. They voted it out. Leslie Marshall, syndicated radio host, and Scott Brown, former Massachusetts senator, both are Fox News contributors. Good to see you both.
Thank you.
Good morning.
Okay, so we're hearing about all kinds of new plans, more beds in the detention centers, more immigration judges, more Border Patrol agents. Leslie, do you have objections in principle to any of those things?
Absolutely. First of all, President Trump was elected to do two things, keep us safer and to create jobs. This mass deportation idea does neither. Adding 33,000 beds to already deplorable conditions with a four-year-plus backlog in the courts, the amount of people that they're looking to hire, where the funds are coming from, Congress isn't necessarily going to approve it, doesn't address any of that. Some of these people have been here for decades. Some of these people are not criminal. And the reality is that the overwhelming majority of our crimes are by Americans, not by illegals that have come over the Rio Grande, and that includes mass shootings and terrorism. So it does not address two of the A and B, if you will, that got this president elected. And this is going to be counterproductive, right. And I think it'll come back to hurt Republicans in the future.
Okay, let's bring in Senator Brown. I can hear him chomping at the bit, but you know, one of the things that the president did during his campaign was to highlight these cases where there was violence by these individuals who were here illegally. Essentially, if they'd killed someone, murdered someone, raped someone, those things would not have happened had those individuals not been in the country. Senator, do you think he gets anywhere with this? Because as Leslie said, there's a lot of skepticism about the funding for this. It would cost a lot of money.
Sure. I actually have a lot of respect for Leslie and have to respectfully disagree with her. He was elected to do quite a few more things, and that's to secure our border and make sure that we do not have people who are here illegally and actually are criminals because they have broken our law, regardless of whether they're just here without the proper documentation or not. So he was elected not only to secure the border, create jobs, and do a whole host of other things. The fact that he's finally doing what many other presidents, not just President Obama, but prior presidents have not done is a good thing. And there is a tremendous amount of money in the system right now. They just have to find it and obviously shift, consolidate, streamline to get the monies immediately. And I think General Sessions is going to do a great job, and as well as former General Kelly, because as you know, he was a Southcom commander. There's no one who knows that region and the problems associated with that region more than Secretary Kelly.
Yeah, and Leslie, very tough talk from the attorney general yesterday saying it is a new era. There's a new sheriff in town. It's the Trump era. Don't come to the border. It's closed. It's not open for business. I mean, he talked about felony prosecutions of people who come here multiple times. He wants to enable judges and prosecutors to do things that are more of a crackdown. He says, and the numbers are there, showing an enormous drop in attempted border crossings and people coming here illegally just since Trump has taken office. So is the tough talk in a way helping to eradicate the problem of people coming here so they don't get stuck in those detention centers and they don't get stuck in limbo for 4 or 5 years?
I think that, quite frankly, although the Trump administration wants to pat itself on the back for this, if you look at the numbers, for 10 years, immigration has month by month been dropping, and that was largely in part to the economy. I mean, the reason people were coming here was they weren't fleeing persecution in Mexico. They were fleeing lack of opportunity and jobs, and somebody was dangling the carrot of opportunity and employment. And this doesn't address any of that. This is not mass deportation. This is mass relocation to these detention centers where there are lots of problems, and quite frankly, there are even some questions as to who profits financially from these detention centers, including some with the name Trump above the real estate holdings. So this is problematic because, one, does it address the criminal element? And with all due respect, Senator, I respect you as well and respectfully disagree. President Obama got a lot of flack not only for liberals, but especially the Hispanic community here in Los Angeles for being being the deporter in chief, if you will. So this does not address what the majority of Americans want, which is not a wall. They don't want economic opportunities taken from them, and they want the criminal element deported. And I think that's something that both sides.
Shannon,
let me very quickly read something from the executive director of the National Immigration Law Center. She says this is an administration that is very much interested in setting up that mass deportation infrastructure and creating the levers of a police state. In these documents, which outline the new changes, you have more proof and evidence that they're planning to carry it out. Senator, that is a characterization that scares a lot of people. So quickly,
you're right. They're going to exaggerate and put all sorts of different types of labels on this. Bottom line is they're enforcing the law and they're fixing a mess that many other presidents have actually let develop. We have an opportunity to get rid of the criminals, the people that are, as you referenced in the beginning of your show, who are hurting, killing, raping our citizens. There are others here who have broken the law. They're using false Social Security numbers, getting benefits that they're not entitled to. And bottom line is they need to follow the law, and there needs to be a mechanism to address it. Yeah, it's simple as that.
And those are the cases that the Attorney General said he wants to see prioritized.
Sure.
Senator Brown, Leslie Marshall, good to see you both.
All right, Shannon. Thank you. 10 minutes.